to stop believing what you believed before in the rightness of whiteness. You've got to realize that there's only one race. You've got to realize if you, what you want to call yourself is fine, as long as you don't say it's a race. As long as you stop talking about racial differences, as long as you stop, you want to talk about color differences, go ahead. You want to talk about religious differences, go ahead. There are lots of differences, but they are not differences that make us better or worse. They are differences that make us different.
So do you trust what these people are saying? Do you trust that these whites are now, these pale-faced people are now?
I am so inspired that people of all colors are out there demonstrating and protesting in protest of what is happening to black people. What happened to black people this month, black person this month? But those things have been happening to black people for the last 300 years. And we have elected a fool who says, first comes the looting and then comes the shooting. He's got that wrong. First we came to this country and first we shot them and then we took over their land after we had killed as many as we can. It's what we have been doing. It is called building an empire. That's what we white folks do because we are ignorant. Make no mistake about this. We know that if we can perpetuate the ignorance in the white population of this country, that we can perpetuate this idiocy for as long as we hold on to our, as long as people like those on the business roundtable make the decisions in this country, that's how long we'll hold on to the idiocy of race, of racism. Racism is the result of poor education, but education that people who have power want to continue, want to perpetuate indefinitely. What we have in this country does not teach people to love one another. It teaches them to love people who look like them. And white people with my color skin are more valuable and more lovable. This is nonsense.
Well, we all believe in the golden rule and we want to institutionalize.
No, I don't. I do not.
You don't believe in the golden rule? I do.
Heavens, well, I don't think you do. Do unto others as you would have others do. Wait a minute. The golden rule says in my Bible, do unto others as you would have others do unto you. Treat others the way you want to be treated. All right, and I get on an airplane, wait a minute. If you and I get on an airplane and I have a piece of luggage to put in the overhead rack, and you say to me, can I put that up for you, ma'am? I'm going to say, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. However, if we get on an airplane and you have a piece of luggage to put in the overhead rack, and I say, can I do that for you, Sonny? You're going to say, I think I can handle it myself. I happen to know that not everyone wants to be treated the way I want to be treated. Younger people don't want to be treated the way I want to be treated. People of other colors groups don't want to be treated the way I want to be treated. People of different religious groups don't want to be treated the way I want to be treated. I believe in the platinum rule, which says, do unto others as others would have you do unto them. In other words, you have to ask them what they want. You have to listen to their answers. And listening is the hardest thing that we do. Listen to their answers, and then if what they ask you to do is illegal, indecent, or immoral, you have to do it. But the first thing you have to do is listen to what they say. I don't treat others the way I want to be treated. I try to treat others the way they want to be treated, because that way we can
communicate. Well, you can actually have both. You can have both, because I think the Christian conception of the golden rule is that no one would choose to be hated, dominated, subjugated, exploited, and violated. Now, if people want to be dominated and violated, that's a different thing. But the assumption is they don't, because they have a dignity made in the image of God. So that the golden rule, broadly understood, can embrace what you're talking about. But I think, again, where I'm challenging you in the good spirit is when you talked about empire. When you talk about empire, you got to talk about military aspect, you got to talk about land, gold, resources that people want access to. So it's not going to be just the ignorance of founding an empire. When they came to the New World to engage in the land of indigenous peoples, it wasn't just the ignorance. It was the ignorance that you talk about, but it was a whole lot more too, my dear sister. It was they wanted their land. They wanted the gold in that land. They wanted resources in that land. That's called interest. And interests are not the same thing as ignorance. Both become the pillar of these lies, like white supremacy or male supremacy or any other lie. The lies about Jewish folk, the lies about Arabs, the lies about Muslims, the lies about Mexicans. But as long as you talk only about ignorance and education, it only take you so far. You've got to talk about power and interest as well. That's what I'm challenging you. But tell me where I'm wrong.
Well, I think we're proving that you're wrong, because right now there are a whole lot of people who were ignorant about what was really going on. And now they are seeing the light, and they are seeing how this really works. And they're saying, we're not going to put up with this. They're saying maybe police departments shouldn't have that kind of power. They're saying maybe there's something wrong with the system. There is something wrong with the system. And what's wrong with the system is we don't know history. We don't study history. We only study things. I suspect that in most social studies books at any level, the Holocaust maybe covers 2 or 3 paragraphs. That was, when I watch what is happening in the streets of the United States since Mr. Trump's election. I have watched things happen that I watched happen when I was 8, 9, 10 years old. We are now replicating what happened in Germany. But the first thing that scared me was what I saw happening was what I did in my third grade classroom with the blue-eyed, brown-eyed exercise. This man is doing exactly that. He's replicating what Hitler did. And I learned the exercise from Hitler. I separated my students according to color eyes because that's what he did. That's one of the ways he decided who went into the gas chamber. Now, I see happening in this country today exactly what happened in my third grade classroom. You pick out a group of people on the basis of a physical characteristic over which they have absolutely no control. You assign negative traits to them because of that physical characteristic. You lower your expectations for them. You force them to live down to your expectations of them. And when they do, you can say, see, you're all like that. And it's because of that physical characteristic. Now, we know how to do that. I'm talking about we, the people who run this show. We know how to do that. And we have learned it from masters. We're doing it today. We should have known better after history. And I thought we did know better when we finished the Second World War. I thought things are going to be better. And then we had to go someplace else to help them start a war. And then someplace else. And then someplace else. It's all about power. It's all about oil. It's all about natural resources. It's all about keeping the we in power. I know that.
That's my point. We're talking about power now.
If you do a good enough job of educating people, you will educate them to realize that once you get on top, then all you have to do for the rest of the time is see to it that nobody knocks you down.
I think we're reaching an agreement here. Ignorance and the interest.
Well,
the
we were in agreement when you asked me to be on this thing, but now you want me to go along to get along. No, I will not. I know that individuals can make a difference.
I want to thank you so much for joining us on the tightrope. Make sure you subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss out on the rich weekly conversations with me and my dear sister Tricia. We're right here on the tightrope.